What happens is its electrical resistance changes this material when it's bent, and then that's how it tries to interpret how much it should show the joint bending right there. My research is in the area of designing animations of American Sign Language that would have benefits for people who are deaf or hard of hearing and who use American Sign Language to communicate. If you look at educational statistics for people who are deaf graduating high school, the average literacy skill in written English for deaf adults is around the level of a fourth grade child. Many people who grow up deaf do not develop enough skill at reading and writing in English. So part of it has to do with the idea that normally infants will hear their parents using the language around them and they practice and learn those patterns. For a deaf child, they're never going to experience spoken English being used around them in context as an infant, and they're not going to develop that skill in English. And if you can produce animations that are easier to understand and move more in the way that humans do, then people who are deaf might be able to understand the information that's presented in the form of sign language more easily than if it had been presented in English text. People have been trying to design animation systems for American Sign Language maybe for about 15 years or so. Right now, what you'd have to do to make a really beautiful sign language animation is do the same kind of work that a movie studio would do to make an animated picture, where for a minute of video, you'd have hundreds, well, dozens of hours of time of a human planning all the movements of the character. What our laboratory would like to do is let you tell us, I want a sentence with these six signs, and our software will produce a natural-looking sentence with those six signs. So we use a variety of equipment. We use motion capture data gloves. We also use a bodysuit that looks like a spandex suit that has little sensors attached to it, similar to the technology in the Wii remote that's part of people's video game systems. They also wear a head-mounted sensor that tells us where their head is in the room. So that way, we know how their eye is aimed, we know where their head is, and so we can tell where they're looking in a room. Within the US, our laboratory is the leading site for studying how to produce animations of American Sign Language. I think what's unique about us within the United States is that we have a lot of participation of people who are deaf in our project, and we collect a lot of samples of signing from those people so that the movements of our animated characters are based mathematically on the ways that actual humans were moving to do those signing.
I have been working with Matt in this project for 4 years, and in the first 3 years, we've been working hard to collect the motion capture coppers using the equipment. And I feel very interesting working with deaf students. I found my work is very useful for them.
So what I'd like you to do is aim your head and sort of focus it sort of towards the center, and then hold your head still, but then just look with your eyes at each of these points. So are you ready?
Yes.
Okay.
This is my first year. I always like human-computer interaction and using all what I'm learning, hopefully to help people.
Number two.
Up to now, I'm working on this stuff and reading on how it is possible to represent facial expressions and what tool we have to use to model them.
Number eight, I think one of the big advances that's going to come about from sign language animation technology is that we're going to see animated characters with signing in more places. Basically, it's producing a smarter dictionary of signs that lets someone with less effort produce the customized version of each sign that they need to create a particular sentence or message.